Let's see what you guys know about factoring. You know, I'm going to start with a nice, easy example. This is the kind of stuff that makes us all happy to be in a math class. Right? I mean, aren't you happy? I know that I'm always happy. I've got to factor this guy. This is your standard trinomial. Love trinomials. What's the, you know, before you even get here, what's the first thing you always do when you're factoring? What?
Check for common factor.
Always look for the greatest common factor. Always. Because if you don't, none of the tricks or the techniques that I taught you or that you would see on the videos, none of that will apply unless you look for the GCF. Is there a common factor for everybody here?
No.
No. This is a trinomial. I expect it to factor as two binomial factors. Does it?
Yeah.
How?
9 and 3 plus 9 plus 3. 12
and 3.
I'm sorry. 12.
X plus 12 and
yeah,
plus 3.
Excuse me.
Some of us are having a special day today.
It's early.
Are you kidding?
My brain still isn't.
Dude, it's in the middle of, you know.
I didn't sleep well last night.
It's the middle of The Price is Right. It can't be that early. Yes, of course I watched that because I'm doing it right now on TV. Good grief. What is that?
No.
Funny?
Private conversation.
Oh, is it an A-B conversation that I need to see my way out of?
Hey, the price is wrong, okay?
Price is wrong, Bob. Love TV edits. Let's try this one. X squared minus XY minus 56Y squared. Is there a common factor for everybody?
No.
No! So then I look at the number of terms. It tells me what to do. I've got three terms, two binomial factors. That's all we got to do. So how does it break down? Come on, don't have a frown. And don't act like Doug. And you know what? I think he needs a hug. X squared breaks down as X times X. What do you know about your signs? 1 minus 1 plus, because you have to multiply to get a negative. You're right. Since I have a negative middle term, the negative number must be larger. I've got Y squared to break down along with the 56. How do we break down the Y squared? As Y and Y. Now, these guys have opposite signs. That means when I'm adding them, I have to do the difference of the absolute values. So the difference has to be the same as this guy right here, which is a 1. How do you multiply to get 56, but the numbers are off by 1? 7 and 8, so that's minus 8 and plus 7. Do y'all agree? You're looking happy, Jess.
I always look unhappy.
Oh, you're just like me. You got the whole Darth Vader expression, right? Happy. Sad.
Watched.
Surprised. I do them all at the same time.
Don't
worry, Darth Vader was not in Star Trek. You're safe there. Check on the inside, that's minus 8y. Check on the outside, it's plus 7xy. By the way, anything you say can and most likely will be used against you in the course of this class. So that combines to give you a negative xy. Everything checks out. Do you all agree?
Yep.
I am so happy. You're happy too, we're all happy. You know what, if we just do trinomials like this, this gets very boring, right? Let's do fun things. Let's see, what do I have here? Sure, why not? Time to factor. Is there a common factor for everybody other than one?
No.
No. So the next thing to do is to look at the number of terms. How many terms do I have?
Four.
Is this a trinomial?
No.
Then we do not use the trinomial thought process to factor this. I've got four terms. How do I factor with four terms?
Grouping.
Factor by grouping, right? What's the common factor in the first group?
X squared.
X squared, and what are we left with?
2x.
I get 2x and minus 3. Do you all agree? In the second group, which begins with a negative, if you remember, I get very upset when you lead off with a negative. What must I do? What? Say it louder so we can hear you.
Take out the negative
along with the GCF of?
3.
So remember, when you take out a common factor, it's as though you're dividing it out of all of those terms. If I take negative 6x divided by negative 3, what do you get?
2x.
Positive 2x. What's positive 9 divided by negative 3?
11.
And you see here, oh, we're so happy now. Because what happens there? Nothing. We just sit and stare. What?
That's the first part of our answer.
I would say that's 2x minus 3, and what's the other factor?
X squared minus 3.
How do you know this answer is right? You can check it by doing what?
Multiplying.
Take it by multiplying it all out. I need to go find my kitty corrector and spritz some of you guys, I guess. Multiply it all out, and it should get back to the original. Now, I could write this, or, because I know how some of you guys are, some of you would write it like this. X squared minus 3 and then 2x minus 3. Is there a difference between these two answers? No. Why is there not a difference between these two? It's multiplication. As Mr. Craig has said once, several times before. What's the great thing about multiplication? Order does not matter. Multiplication has this fantastic property called commutativity. Love it. Love it, love it, love it. Questions about that?
Yes.